Hello friends, let us discuss how the quality of service is achieved by using the integrated service model. So let us start with the quality of service. The two models have been designed to provide the quality of service. That the first model is nothing but integrated service and the second model is nothing but differentiated service. Both the model emphasize the use of quality of service at the network layer. So basically here with the help of network layer we are achieving the quality of service. Although the model can be used in the other layer such as data link layer. So basically we are try to achieve the quality of service at the network layer. Even this model is work with the other layers also. So in this section, we're going to discuss about the integrated services. As we learn in the earlier chapter that IP was originally designed to be best efforts delivery. Basically, as you know, the IP protocol, best effort delivery, means it does not provide you any error correction, any congestion control, any congestion avoidance, even the flow controls, whatever the packet you are sending from the sender, it does not give you the any guarantee that packet will reach to the destination. That is called as a best effort delivery. This means that the every user receives the same level of service. So basically here, the every user will get the same level of service, means this the best effort service we can't use for the multimedia communication, because as you know the different application having the different requirement. So with the help of best effort service you are dealing all the packet equally. This type of delivery does not guarantee the minimum of service such as bandwidth to applications such as real-time audio video. So basically we can't use the best effort delivery for the multimedia application, but because it does not provide you the minimum delay, maximum throughput, what are the requirement of the application. If such an application accidentally get the extra bandwidth, it may be detrimental to the other application, result into the congestion. So it is not do the special handling to for the special packet. So it may possible the congestion may take place in the network. Integrated service is sometimes called it as INSERV. Is a flow based quality of service model. Basically the integrated service, it will provide you the quality of service per flow, which means that the user need to create the flow, a kind of virtual circuit from source to that of destination, and inform all the routers of the resource requirement. So basically here we're going to form the flow. And your flow is taking which path, whatever the routers come in between, you have to inform that router this much resource you have to reserve for this flow, or whatever the requirement of flow, you have to inform the router about it. So basically the integrated service is a, it is basically implement the quality of service per flow. Integrated service is an architecture to specify the element to guarantee the quality of service. So basically with the help of integrated service, it will provide you the guaranteed quality of service. INSERV can be used to delete the receiver interruption from the video and the sound. The INSERV idea is let the every router in the system implement INSERV and let every application require some kinds of guarantee to make an individual reservation. So basically the INSERV, it will provide you the resource reservation, and this resource reserve at every router. The integrated service structure can be implemented through the following. So now how the we going to achieve the quality of service? How we going to reserve the resource? So that is achieved by the signaling protocol, and the second is the admission control routing. So admission control routing, and the second we going to achieve with the help of signaling protocol. The based on as per flow resource reservation, the app must make the reservation before the transmitting traffic. As you know, here we're going to form the virtual network between the source and destination. Means you are going to reserve the path. So first what it will do, it will first do the reservation, and then once the reservation is done, then he will pass the traffic. The app characterizes its traffic and the resource requirement. Network uses the routing protocol to find the path. So first you have to find out your packet will flow in what path. So for that, to find the path between the source and the destination, how it is achieved? First you have to take help of the routing protocol. A reservation protocol is used to install the reservation state along the path. Now what we do next? Now then we will do the reservation between the paths with the help of reservation protocol. At each hop, admission control check whether the sufficient resource are available to accept the new reservation. So first, whenever he is expecting the new reservation, first it will find out that much bandwidth is available or not. Then only he will take the new reservation. So here we are going to do the admission control. A resource reservation enforced by the packet classification and the scheduling mechanism. So then we will go for the reservation. So how it is possible? The reservation is done with the first technique, that is a packet classification, and the second is a packet scheduling. Means which packet to be sent first. First we are going to divide the packet according to the application requirement, and then how to send the packet, that we will done with the help of packet scheduling. The two new service models were introduced. The first is guaranteed service and the second is a control load service. So here we are, it is provide you the two things. The first is what guaranteed service and the second is a control load. Now let us discuss about what you mean by the guaranteed service. So it will provide you deterministic worst case delay. So guaranteed delay means it will be provide you the best possible that there will be a less delay. Second is a control load provide the less firm guarantee. So guaranteed service means you will get the lowest delay, but in the control load it will give you a less firm guarantee, means not the exact whatever you are asking, you it will not provide you the same thing. So here there will be less firm guarantee. It is close to light loaded best effort network. So basically this service is nothing but it is exactly like to that of best effort service. The overhead of setting up reservation is high. So here what happened? First you have to do the reservation. This main disadvantage of this is scalability problem. The backbone will have the large number of flow and keeping the flow information is not feasible. So as you know, here we are dividing the traffic per flow and we are providing the reservation to all the flow. So different flow having the different requirement. The each router has to remember what is the requirement of the flow. So that is a very difficult task. Now first we'll discuss about what do you mean by the best effort model. The internet was initially based upon the best effort packet delivery service. So initially before this technique we make use of the best effort is a default mode for all the traffic. There is no differentiation among the type of traffic. So here in the best efforts means what? All the packets are treated equally. Here it is not like that the higher priorities are handled with care and than that of lower priority. All the packets having the equal priority and they handle in the same manner. The best effort is similar to using the standard meal. It will get there when it get there. So that it is like first in, first out type. So this is my existing network. And now here the packet is sending between the source and the destination. So here you are sending the three packet, but here when it reaches to the destination, it becomes the two packet. So it does not give you the guarantee. Now here you are sending the two packet, but here it receive, we are able to receive only one packet. So it does not give you the guarantee how many packets you are sending. It will reach exactly in the same manner to the receiver. It may possible that some of the packet get lost. And even it will not send any intimation to the sender these packets are lost. So this is called as a best effort delivery. But this type of service we can't afford for the multimedia communication. So now let us discuss about what is a benefit. High scalable, as you know, this is an AZ technique. There is no complex algorithms are involved. No special mechanisms is required. But the drawbacks are, does not provide you any guarantee. No service differentiation. You are handling all the packet equally. Means we are not classifying the packet according to the priority. So, and also does not give you the guarantee if the packet will reach to the destination. So all these are the disadvantage of the best effort delivery service. Now let us discuss about the basic approach. So now the senders start the setup of reservation by sending the characteristic and the resource requirement of the flow. Now here, after that, instead of the best effort service, now we come up with the new technique that we started reserving the resource. The network can accept the new application flow only if the sufficient resource is available. So if he has enough bandwidth, then only he will take the new reservation. Once the reservation is set up successfully, the application starts sending the data packet. So before sending only the packet, he will first reserve the resource and then he starts sending the packet. So now these are the key components. So here the packet the flow identification we have to done in the InterServe. Basically, these are the important component in the InterServe model. Packet scheduling is done, the packet classification is done, the reservation table setup agent is required for reservation, then queuing routing agent is needed to find out the path, also the admission control, whether the particular reservation to take or not, even the sufficient bandwidth is there or not, then only he will take the new reservation. So all the things we will going to do in the InterServe. So as you know, it is divided into the two plane. The one is control plane and second is a data plane. So this is my data plane and this is my control plane. The control plane set up the resource reservation. The data plane forward the data packet based on the reservation state. So basically, the control plane, what it will deal? It will deal with the resource reservation, where the data plane will see the packet forwarding. To set up the reservation, the app first characterize its traffic flow and the specify the quality of service requirement and refer to the flow specification. So before, whenever it will set up or whenever it reserve, then what thing it will check? First, it will think what are the packet coming from which application. So according to that, it will classify the packet. And secondly, what is a requirement for handling that packet? It will see that also. So that is included in the flow specification. The reservation setup request and then send the network. So once he will reserve the resource and then he will start sending the packet. The router upon getting the request interact with the quality of service routing agent to find the next hop. Then to find the next hop, it take help of routing agent. if they coordinate with the admission control module to determine if there are sufficient resources to meet the requirement. So once it take the resource, it once it have the resource, then only it will take the reservation. If it don't have the bandwidth, then it will not provide you the reservation. Once the reservation is set up successfully, the information for the reserve flow is installed into the resource reservation table. So that information is then again stored into the resource reservation table. Info in the resource reservation table is used to configure the flow identification module and the packet scheduling module in the data plane. So with the help of that table, we're going to find out the flow identification is done in the packet scheduling module and the data plane. So basically, the in-serve module was driven by the real-time application such as a remote video and the conferencing. So basically, the in-serve model is specially designed for the real-time data. In-serve end-to-end model ensure the guaranteed delivery and the predictable behavior of the network for the application. So basically, it will provide you the quality of service. Whatever he agreed to the client, he will try to fulfill that requirement. The resource reservation protocol is used as a signaling protocol. The request of quality service parameter are then linked to the packet stream. End-to-end streams are not established if the required quality of service parameters are not available. If the resource are not available, then you will not able to get that quality of service. So the in-serve model provide you the multiple service level. Request the specific kind of service from the network before the sending data. So you can reserve the resource according to your application before sending the data. User RSVP to reserve the resource for the specified quality of service parameter. Even you can define the particular requirement with the help of in-serve process. The intelligent queuing mechanism required to provide the resource reservation. So basically, here we are using the intelligent queuing technique. So then it will provide you the guaranteed rate and the control load is equivalent to the best effort delivery service, but it will provide you the low delay and the high throughput. It tried to give you the low delay and the high throughput. These two classes is there in the in-serve model. As well as in-serve give you the additional function that in-serve require the several function on the router and switch along the path. So whenever he's sending the any data per flow, he has to take care of all this thing also. The first is a admission control, second is a classification of the packet, policing, next is queuing and scheduling. So let us discuss about this in detail. Then the classifier is also there for packet scheduling. The packet scheduler is there. This model requires the explicit signaling mechanism to convey the information to the router so that they can provide the request resource. The RSVP is one of the most widely known examples such as the signaling mechanism. So just now we discussed, we need the signaling protocol. For the resource reservation, we are using the RSVP signaling protocol. Now let us start with the signaling. The reader may remember that IP is a connectionless datagram packet switching protocol. As you know, the IP protocol that does not provide you any flow control, any error control. So because of that, it is called as a connectionless protocol. How can we implement the flow-based model over the connectionless protocol? So you are using the IP network. So how to provide the flow-based model? Because here you are giving the guarantee. For the particular application, you are giving the guarantee that you are getting the maximum throughput or minimum delay. So how to achieve that? The solution is that the signaling protocol to run over the IP and provide the signaling mechanism for making the reservation. So now here you need to introduce the one more protocol which take care of all these things. So here we are using the RSVP which make the reservation for your resource. So this protocol is called as a resource reservation protocol. So before sending the data, it will reserve the resource for particular flow. Because of that, it is called as a resource reservation protocol. Now let us discuss about what you mean by the flow specification. When a source make a reservation, it need to define the flow specification. So before making a reservation, he has to give the information about the flow specification. So flow specification having the two parts. The first is a resource specification and the second is a traffic specification. You have to specify about the resource, what type of resource you want and what traffic it is. So the resource specification define the resource that flow needs, what the bandwidth it is needed, what the buffer size it is needed, and in the T-spec that define, that is nothing but traffic specification, the traffic characteristic of the flow. What is a characteristic of the flow? That is also important. So before to reserve the resource, this thing you need to define, what is a resource specification and what is a traffic specification. Now the reservation setup. To set up the reservation, a reservation set protocol is needed that goes up hop by hop along the path to install the reservation state in the router. So basically to make the reservation, it is necessary that we have to use the reservation protocol. So with the each hop, it will going to reserve that path. The reservation protocol must also deal with the change in the network topology. Even you make the any changes in the network topology, the reservation protocol play a very important role in that also. In InServe, the RSVP has been develop as the resource reservation protocol. So basically in InServe model, we are using the RSVP protocol. The RSVP is a signaling protocol that allow the resource reservation to be coordinates in the network. So the resource management is done by the RSVP. The RSVP signaling generally result in the resource being reserved in the RSVP capable router in the transit path of the traffic flow. So basically in the RSVP signaling protocol is resource reserved with the help of RSVP capable routers. So all that information is going to store in the RSVP capable routers. Each of this router maintain the soft state that need to be periodically refreshed. As you know, this RSVP protocol, all that information, what is the requirement of the packet flow, all that information is stored in the soft state, and that should be periodically updated, because if any change take place, that is again carry forwarded to all the routers. The RSVP is unidirectional resource reserved only in one direction from the source to the destination. Basically, it is unidirectional reservation protocol. You can reserve resource only in one direction. Now see here, this is my receiver and this is my source. Here the pack reservation of the path take place like this. So here the reservation is done by the from source to that of destination. And this is all, these are nothing but RSVP capable routers. Now let us discuss about in the admission control what happened. The admission control referred to the decision whether to admit a certain flow or the aggregation of the flow into the network in response to the request for the resource reservation. So whether whenever he want to do commitment that this reservation is provided, but before that he has to check whether that much bandwidth is available to itself or not. If the bandwidth is not available, then it can't provide the reservation. So whether whenever he taking any reservation, first it check out whether that much resource is available or not. It makes sense for the admission control decision to be made by the entity with an overall network resource. So first it will find out that much resource is available and then only it take the reservation. Next is a packet classification and marking. So of course the packet classification is done over here. The packet classification means the separation of the packet into the different classes based on some criteria. How the packets are classified in the integrated service. Classification may be a port base, that is input or the output port, that is the classification is depend upon that. And second, which protocol you are using, whether you are using the TCP or you are using the UDP. So according to that, the classification is take place. The application base, such as the HTTP base, again, the classification is also depend upon the address base. So based on the source or the destination address of the packet. It also possible the out of profile packets are reclassified typically into the lower priority classes. So in such a way, the classification of the packet is done. Next is what do you mean by the marking of the packet? The marking means the setting of the bit in the packet header corresponding to that of packet class. So we are assigning the priorities over here according to the classes. The bit mark could be 3-bit in this type of service field and the 3 bits for the precedence field in the IP header. So basically how to define, how to mark. So there is a TOS field in the IP header and the second is a precedence field. Over there, we're going to mark the option. The packet classification and the marking allow the differential treatment of the different packet classes using the other complementary service. So with the help of the classification of the packet, we can handle each packet differently. A packet classification and marking may be handled by the external source like the customers and the other network. So packet classification can be handled by the other network or the customers. Now let us discuss about what you mean by the packet scheduling. The packet scheduling is responsible for resource allocation. So as you know, the packet scheduling you can use for the resource allocation. Directly affect the delay, jitter and the packet loss. It is very important, the packet scheduling is very important to avoid the delay, avoid the jitter and avoid the packet loss. The primary task is to select the packet to transmit when the outgoing link is ready, such as the quality of service promised to flow is provided. Now basically, to get the particular data rate, it is necessary that whether that much resource is available or not. So here outgoing link should be free, then only you will get the particular data rate. So it will first task is to select the packet to transmit when the outgoing link is ready. When the resource is ready, that time only it will send the packet. Then only he will able to achieve the required flow or the required data rate. Next is a flow identification. The router must examine every incoming packet and decide whether the packet belongs to one of the reserve flow. So now how he come to know that whether the particular flow or the whether the particular packet is belongs to which flow? The IP flow is identified by SRC address, test address, then proto ID, SCRC port, DST port. So there are the different index to identify the particular packet is belongs to which flow. This 5 field of incoming packet is compare against the 5 tulip of all the flow in the reservation table for the flow identification. If all the 5 fields are similar, means that packet is belongs to that of particular flow. Describe the interface between the network and its user. So basically the service model will define what? It provides the interface between the network and its users. The InServe has a standard 2 basic model. The first is a guaranteed service and the second is a control load service. In the flow specification, a service contract that specify the traffic the source will send. So basically here there will be a contract. So it will provide you the specific data rate. If the application violates the contract, then it may not get the quality of service expected. So the particular application didn't follow the rules. Then what will happen? The particular quality of service cannot be achieved for that application. This is done by the policing the traffic to ensure or to confine to its traffic description. So who will do that to find out who is violating the service? That function is done by the traffic policing. The flow characterization. So here the peak rate, as you know, that is nothing but highest rate at which the source can generate the traffic. Peak rate means what? The maximum processing speed can be calculated from the packet size and the spacing between the 2 packets. So processing speed is depend upon what is the packet size and what is how much distance between the 2 packets. Average rate means average transmission rate over the time interval. Typically calculated with the moving time of the window. So average rate you will get with the help of moving time in the window. Burst means what? The maximum amount of data that can be injected at the peak rate is called as a burst rate. In InServe, the traffic is described in the 2 leaky bucket parameter. It has 2 parameters, the token arrival rate and the bucket depth rate. So as you know, for the traffic shaping, we are using which technique? The token bucket technique. So it is depend upon what is the arrival rate and as well as what is the depth of the token bucket. Token get into bucket at the rate R and the packet is sent only if there are enough tokens. So as we discuss in the token bucket only, how much tokens are available, that much packet you can set. When the packet is sent, the token equal to that of packet size is removed from the bucket. So each packet is consumed 1 token. Now basically in the guaranteed service, what we get? Provide the guaranteed bandwidth and strict bound of delay. So in the guaranteed service, it will provide you the minimum delay and it will provide you the guaranteed bandwidth. Intended for the app that require the highest assurance on the bandwidth and delay. The mission critical app and the intolerant playback app. So basically this, which app we are using the guaranteed services, the first is intolerant playback app, we go for the guaranteed service. So in that case, we need a very less delay. So we go for the guaranteed service. can be viewed as a virtual circuit with the guaranteed bandwidth. So basically, in the guaranteed bandwidth means what? It will make the virtual circuit between the sender and the receiver. Provide the bound on the maximum queuing delay. So basically, queuing delay is also considered in the guaranteed service. Now let us discuss about in the control load service, what we are going to consider. Strict bandwidth assurance and delay bound comes at the price. The resource have to be reserved for the worst case. So here the resource is reserved for the worst case. Sum up, the service model with the less strict guarantee and the lower cost would be better serve this need. So in the some application, you need the packet loss is acceptable, even the delay is acceptable. In that case, you can go for this service. A very high percentage of packet will be successfully delivered by the network to the receiver. So basically, it may possible, may all the packet may reach to the receiver, but it does not give you the guarantee. And you know, here in this case, the processing speed is faster. Means here the packet is transmitted at the faster rate. The transit delay experienced by the very high percentage of packet will not be greatly exceed the minimum delay. So in this case, it is may possible the delay factor comes. Sometimes whenever there is less congestion, then what the delay will be less. If there is a more congestion, the delay will be more. So delay factor is going to be added. So now let us discuss about what are the disadvantage. Every device along the path of the packet need to be fully aware of RSVP and capable of signaling the required quality of service. As you know, we're going to make the soft state, and each router should know about the soft state information. Soft state information means what the reservation is needed. So whenever the flow is passing through the particular router, he has to know that the particular flow, how to handle or what reservation is needed for it. So here, if there are large number of flow, then the router has to store the lot of information. The reservation in each device along the path are soft, which means they are need to periodically update. So here, we are using the soft state. So here, every after certain period, it need to be updated. If there is any changes, the all router has to know that information. So periodic updation is also important. Adding to the traffic on the network. So because of that, there will be a traffic is added into the network, increasing the chances that the reservation may time out and the refresh packets are lost. So due to the periodic updation, what happens sometimes, it may possible that the reservation may time out and because of that packet loss take place. So all these are the disadvantage of the integrated service. Thank you.